As his studies come to a close, the historian faces the challenge. Of what use have your studies been? Have you found in your work only the amusement of recounting the rise and fall of nations and ideas, and retelling sad stories of the death of kings? Have you learned more about human nature than the man in the street can learn without so much as opening a book? Have you derived from history any illumination of our present condition? Is it possible that, after all, history has no sense, that it teaches us nothing, and that the immense past was only the weary rehearsal of the mistakes that the future is destined to make on a larger stage and scale? At times we feel so, and a multitude of doubts assail our enterprise. To begin with, do we really know what the past was, what actually happened? Or is history a fable not quite agreed upon? Our knowledge of any past event is always incomplete, probably inaccurate, beclouded by ambivalent evidence and biased historians, and perhaps distorted by our own patriotic or religious partisanship. Most history is guessing, and the rest is prejudice. Even the historian who thinks to rise above partiality for his country, race, creed, or class betrays his secret predilection in his choice of materials and in the nuances of his adjectives. The historian always oversimplifies and hastily selects a manageable minority of facts and faces out of a crowd of souls and events whose multitudinous complexity he can never quite embrace or comprehend.
Getting psyched.
Oh God.
November 27, 1978, in San Francisco, Mayor George Moscone and City Supervisor Harvey Milk, a gay rights activist, are shot to death at City Hall. Former City Supervisor Dan White, who pulled the trigger, goes on trial for murder, but he's convicted of voluntary manslaughter. In what's dubbed the Twinkie defense, White's attorneys argue their client's junk food habits impaired his judgment. 1973, in Washington, the U.S. Senate confirms Gerald Ford as Richard Nixon's vice president. Ford succeeds Spiro Agnew, who had resigned amid accusations that he took bribes. The following year, Ford becomes president after the Watergate scandal forces Nixon from office.
Moment, the chosen one learned a valuable lesson about iron claws. They hurt like crap, man.
Is about to kick his first butt.
Oh.
a lifetime of training.
Hmm.
20th Century Fox invites you to feel the fury. Taste the passion. The Chosen One has returned.
If you truly are the Chosen One, then you must bear the sacred mark.
To deliver the people from the forces of darkness. And to check out the hotties.
I'm sorry?
And witness the utter madness.
I am Ooby-Doo Benooby. I have the silliest name in the galaxy.
What's your middle name?
Scooby-Dooby.
Ooby-Doob Scooby-Dooby Benooby?
Do not underestimate the power of the thumb.
Oh, don't try to scare us with your Ooby-Dooby magic talk helmet, man. I'm a horrifying warlock, and I'm going to get you with my mystic potions talk sickens me.
Any other comments?
I have a question. Why do we all speak in British accents when we are from outer space and there is no Britain?
Gotta keep moving.